This video provides an introduction to security incident response and shows you how to get started using the application. Link timecodes for these topics appear in the YouTube description for this video. ServiceNow Security Operations is a security orchestration, automation, and response engine built on the Now platform. It's designed to help security teams respond faster and more efficiently to incidents and vulnerabilities by using intelligent workflows, business prioritization, and a deep connection with IT to streamline security response and improve visibility. Security Incident Response, or SIR, one of the applications in security operations, allows you to track security incidents, analyze and contain threats, and eradicate them from your network. It provides playbooks containing tasks which associate relevant knowledge base articles to help security analysts quickly resolve incidents. It also creates post-incident reviews which allow the team to learn from and improve their incident handling. So, where do these security incidents come from? Primarily, data from your existing security tools and Security Information and Event Manager, or SIEM, are imported via APIs or email alerts to automatically create prioritized security incidents. These sources can also be imported into event management if additional curation is needed prior to creating a security incident. Any user can submit security incidents via the Security Incident Catalog. And those with a Security Incident Basic role can submit security incidents in the platform via the Security Incident Form, which can be accessed by navigating to any security incident list and clicking New, or by accessing the Security Incident's New UI and clicking Create Incident. You need this application installed by your system administrator to use the new UI. Please consult the documentation on how to install this application. Users can also send or forward an email to an address designated by your organization for reporting suspected security issues, such as phishing attacks, as we'll see in a moment. So what happens to these security incidents? To see, let's look at the security incident response process, which is defined by how you set up the application. But first, you need to purchase a subscription by contacting your ServiceNow account manager, then activate the plugin within your production instance. In step one, you integrate your security products, managed security service provider, MSSP, or a combination of the two with security incident response. ServiceNow provides pre-built integrations for many commonly used products. In the second step, SIR automatically prioritizes incoming security incidents based on your criteria, leveraging the CMDB to map threats to business services and IT infrastructure. In the third step, security incidents are automatically enriched with data from your third-party threat intelligence sources. All of this happens before the security analyst first views the SIR record. In step four, SIR provides playbooks for analysts to follow, which address common security scenarios you can leverage to review security incidents and take recommended action. In step five, you remediate threats fast by leveraging the Now platform to orchestrate action or create tasks, problems, or changes for all affected users and systems. And in the final step, the application creates post-incident reports that you can review and share with your security and IT teams for insight into handling related incidents. Now let's look at an example of using security incident response to resolve a security incident. A user reports a suspicious email by forwarding it to the company's phishing email address. When the forwarded email is received, the system creates a security incident, then parses and analyzes the file. If any suspicious elements, called observables, are found, including IP addresses, MD5 hashes of malware or URLs, or domain names, the system inserts them in the correct fields in the incident record so that automated enrichment and threat lookups can take place. Note that your instance needs to have the Threat Intelligence plugin installed for automatic lookups to be performed. Logged in as a security analyst, we can access security incidents in one of two ways. The classic user interface, or UI, provides filtered incident lists here, as we saw earlier. Or we can launch the new UI, which provides one interface for reviewing all incidents with additional functionality. We can filter by any of these options and further filter the results with these quick filters. We have a new incident in the system. Where did it come from? We can immediately determine this by viewing the description. This one was created from a user-reported phishing attempt. We can also get a quick preview of it without leaving the list. When we open the incident, we see a comprehensive record of everything related to the incident. The second thing we can quickly determine is, do we have any threat lookup results? In our example, we can see that our third-party vendor, VirusTotal, identified malicious observables in this email, as we can see in the Finding field. The Result Value and Details fields provide more information. We're ready to start working this incident, but where do we start? We can use the playbook, which provides step-by-step direction for analyzing and mitigating incidents. This task is associated with a KB article, providing more detail for completing the task. When we verified with the user that they didn't click any links in the email, we add a work note to document the response and mark this task as complete. And the playbook advances to the next step. We're certain this email is malicious based on the threat lookup results, so we select Yes. This next step directs us to analyze any attachments to the email, which doesn't apply in this case. Now that we've analyzed and verified the threat, we can contain and eradicate it. We open the Explore tab, which allows us to examine users, emails, observables, configuration items, and other incidents that may be related. We look for related incidents as directed, but no, nothing here. The playbook prompts us with the next step, to determine if others received the email. So we return to the Explore tab to search for emails from the same sender or with the same subject line. We view the email and select the items we want to search for. Here we see two emails with that subject were received in the system, sent to the same person, so we mark that task as complete. After completing a few more steps to contain the threat, we move on to the next phase, eradicate. Since we already located the phishing emails in the system, we select them all with one click, select the action to search and delete, and click Run. We can see in the search and delete results that the emails were deleted. We mark this task as completed. And now we're ready to close the incident, so we change the incident state here. But notice that we can't close the incident until we complete the review state. And the Close Incident tab appears. We can request a post-incident review assessment for anyone who worked the incident here. And here we provide the closure information. For the final step, a task assessment link appears, reminding us to complete an assessment for the post-incident review in a timely manner. And now we can close the incident. We've just seen how to work an incident and resolve it using the Security Operations UI. But where can we get a higher level perspective of all security incident activity? The Security Incident Response Explorer dashboard provides a high-level overview of all security incident activity, updated in real time and tailored to the role of the user. Here's the view for a user with the security analyst role. Users may also access the Chief Information Security Officer, or CISO, dashboard, and their view can be tailored accordingly. Here's an example of the overview for a user with the Security Incident Manager or Security Incident Administrator role. And here's an example of the overview for a Chief Information Security Officer. So whether you're an employee reporting a suspected security incident, an analyst working incidents, or a manager monitoring your organization's security posture, Security Incident Response provides the tools you need to report, respond to, and monitor threats. For more information, please see our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.